We are live. Start my screen recording. Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to another episode of Trying to Beat Sam with a drawing. He has laid down a pretty epic ice pick, but can I beat it? We're gonna find out! So this week for a weekly design challenge, we have to design a ice axe, or ice pick, or ice climbing pick. Thankfully, I actually have a bit of experience in this. I have actually done ice climbing before, and I kind of know my way around an ice pick. Whether that's going to help with my drawing, we're going to find out. So, let's, as always, begin. Okay, anyway, yeah, let's just begin. Okay. So, I got an ice axe on my tablet here, just to look what's what. So they seem to have like a few features and, I don't know, let's just get drawing. Enough talk, more draw. Okay, we're in business. Brilliant. So ice axes seem to have either a shovel, I mean they have the pick side, which is how you stay in the ice, and the other side they either have like a hammer to hammer in ice spikes, whatever you call them, or they all have like a sort of a shovel scoop which allows you to clear stuff. I'm gonna go for a hammer pick. So I've got this cool idea for a pick. I'll explain soon. Okay, so as always, the first step is to draw in a really rough sketch, and so that's what I'm doing now. There's literally no rules here. This is you just trying to get the ideas out of your brain onto the paper. This is like, it's freeing, so you know, don't think about it too hard. If you're rubbing out, then you know you're doing it wrong. Thus saying that, I'm just about to rub out. So, this is the fun part, you know. It's supposed to be free and draw as many lines as you want or need. You're trying to get the rough ideas down. I might actually make my brush a bit bigger. By making your brush bigger, it can force you to just be more, you know, just do bigger, bolder strokes, which can often lead to better, more exciting shapes. So I've got this idea of at the top here, I want these lines to sort of come out straight from the pick handle, and then I'm going to have other lines come out from where the metal is, and they're going to both meet like that. It's this sort of branching out like a tree. That's what I'm going for. And there'll be a nice sort of ridge on top. I want a sort of continual sort of thing, and then that sort of bleeds into the hammer part. something like that. It's quite nice. Maybe a few bolts there. Jump under handle. It's always got to be a pick at the curl around at the bottom, one that keeps your hand in place away from the snow. Because when you're up against snow like this, chung chung chung, if the shard is straight, then each time you hit the snow, your hand's going to be against the snow and it's not going to be the pick. But if it bows out from the snow, then you've got the sort of space between. So snow's here, and that bows out, you've got your hand goes in there. So it's very important to have that bow out. And I'm liking this sort of tapered. It's going to be quite a graceful kind of pick, I think. Something like that's quite nice. Accentuate that even more. Like that. Now let's see if I can repeat that down somewhere else. It's good to have a walking spike on the end. Quite liking this. That I might put a circle around it. So this time I'm going to put some more stuff for context because I don't think I did that well last time. So if, for example, and we're just playing here, I need that. Of a guy climbing somehow. I'm Here's me. Climber, dude. Certainly that could work. Alright. As always, let's turn the opacity down and get working. New layer on top. Now this is going to be the slightly more refined sketch. I liked it where it was. Hate when that happens. Okay. Now, fully refined, I'm gonna see if I can draw the whole thing using the rulers and the ellipse tool to do my lines. And that's what I'm gonna teach you today. Let's see if this is possible. So I want the top to be this beautiful sort of flowing edge the whole way across almost. From the edge of the hammer to the tip of the pick. Before I do that, I should probably get my lines in. Get my guidelines. Turn my brush down to a 3.8. Groovy. Now let's jump over to the lip tool. Let's get busy. Hang on, what happened here? And you pass it down even more. this is just a slight rounding, just to make it look a bit. Alright, so sometimes doing a fully straight line can look a bit strange. If you give it a bit of curve, it can sometimes really add to it. Quite like that. Yeah, that's good. Okay, let's figure out what's happening with the pick here. So I've never used the ellipse tool to this extent before, so this is new for me, but it's quite good. I think it works quite well. Now that I've got a few things that might move faster with the pen tool. Just turn the pen tools. So that's nice. You're not liking that tip. You know what? I'm gonna make it follow the curvature around, like the old-fashioned kind of pitch. Just for. Design's sake. Magnifique. I'll draw on the teeth on the next level, I think. Okay, back to using the ellipse. So, sometimes the ellipse tool gets stuck. I can't figure out exactly why it does that, but it does. It's a bit annoying. Frankly honest, the pen tool's working really well. Gotta curve around. Continuing that sort of beautiful pulling out, that sort of spreading out, trying to keep those lines flowing at the top, at the bottom, make for a really nice sort of uniform pick. That's quite nice overall, quite liking that. Just darkening in some of the lines where I think they needed to be darkened in. Next I'll add the teeth. I think maybe that springs a little bit on the big side. Sure, I was gonna do it properly this time. elvish design. Oh yeah, there we are. Redo this bottom, I don't like it that much. And make it more elvish. So to make it more elvish,
yeah.
Has to. I'm trying to avoid pixel pushing, but just trying to get this design right. It's got to be stable enough to hold the axe. Yeah, but that should probably do it. It's kind of cool. It's kind of cool. Quickly chomp to the loo. And we back, beautiful people. And I'm refreshed. Mm-hmm. Alright, whether making this an Elvish style is a mistake, we don't know. But it's fun. And I think that's what... what these weekly design challenges should be. They should be fun. And, you know, experiment. It doesn't have to be proper. Have fun. lead those lines into each other. Now the interesting part with ice axes is they do actually do have a thicker part up in here, which is quite interesting. Not sure why they have that. But they do. Now I'm gonna potentially do a groove in the middle, I'm thinking. That'd be quite elvish. Quite elvish indeed. Or it might just be too calm again. Well, it's kind of ruined it, but it kind of eats them. Okay, I need to figure this out a bit better. Now, do all ice pixels have teeth? Yeah, I think the majority of them do. So I should probably get some teeth. Alright, alright. keep with the style. I'm going to get rid of my hook. Hoping this hook here is a bit more elvish in a sense. Maybe. Kind of. It's raining.
Yeah, for straight lines here, I think. It's kind of cool. I like that.
Am I happy with this? Yeah, I mean, it's different. That's for sure. Gosh, I'm not sure if I like this, but anyway. Might as well keep it going. How are we going with time? Alright, I might pick up for now. So this Elven Shave pick. Mixed feelings about it, to tell you the truth, but I'm committed now. I'm just gonna do it and see what turns out. Could be cool. Could be dumb. Could be cool. But you know, this is just for a fun competition, so I'm not going to give it too much stress. Just going to do it. It's about having fun at the end of the day. Starting to get to the point where I'm pixel pushing, which is not good. So I'm just gonna figure out what's happening. I think it's time for color blocking. What do you think, peeps? I'm gonna measure it down. All right, color blocking time. Okay, let's go with the handle, I guess. So we switch over to our paint tapered, which is full opacity. What color do we want the handle to be? Good question. I'm just going to grab my laptop so I can have some photo reference of Elven stuff. Yeah.
Wakey, wakey.
Typical. Out of battery. Bear with me while I find the charger.
Isn't it the worst when
you gotta have stuff, but you've packed it all away? Oh, that's my trunk, because I'm heading down to Wellington tomorrow for 7 weeks. And you pack all your stuff away. Lo and behold, you need it. The worst. Actually, come to think of it, it's definitely a first world problem, and I shouldn't complain, because on the greater scheme of things, that's not really a problem at all. Get together, Jacob. Have a real problem. Have a real breakdown. Yeah. And we are up. I mean, I'm thinking it's probably going to be some sort of grey. Maybe a purple grey is quite nice. What's that look like? Again, it doesn't matter at the moment, because at the moment, this stage, you're just going around the outline. See, I'm going to turn off the tapered on this brush, because it's not helping. That's better. Again, colour choices don't matter at this point. What you want to do now is you just want to, you should be getting pretty familiar with. It's all about getting the outline done. I'm definitely getting faster at this stage. And this is quite a nice stage because there's not much thinking going on. It's all about, I've changed brushes. What happened there? I'm going to lie the iPad flat so I can rotate it. So we'll hear a bit of scraping and whatever. I'm gonna pop that light underneath that layer because it will probably be drawing through, so I'm just gonna change the color so we know what's what. That's right. Same deal. Yeah, truth, these colours aren't bad. I quite like this sort of purpley grey. It's kind of nice. Let's move you over there and get in the way. What color for the handle? I think I like an ivory would be kind of nice. See what you're doing with this colour. I'm going to just darken it slightly so I can see just what I'm doing. So I'm heading down to Wellington tomorrow. So Wellington is the capital city of Auckland. Wellington is the capital city of New Zealand. I live in Auckland, which is the biggest city in New Zealand. But Wellington is the capital. It's sort of like at the bottom of the North Island. It's where a lot of the filming and stuff happens. Where the workshops there. I have been to the city before a couple times, but I only stayed there for short periods of time. I've never done 7 weeks. So it's going to be really interesting seeing a new city and living there. I'm really enjoying currently this sort of nomadic lifestyle. It's been really cool. And it's been an amazing opportunity to be able to do all this. And that wouldn't have been possible without a YouTube channel. I feel very blessed. Alright, that's that hand I filled in. Now this bottom thing, what do I want that to be? Let's just go real dark for now. Undo that. What's that little smudged one there? I don't want that smudge. Oh yeah, if you ever want a colour pick, that tool is down in this little button down at the bottom here. You click that, and you got your eyedropper tool. From here, you can also go back to the last paintbrush, which is the one on the left. I'm not sure what that one does. Background colour. Not in the faintest clue what that one does. But the colour picker I use all the time.
All right, let's choose gallets. It's quite nice. I love this cover because it often tells you colours that it would go with, which is quite cool. I made it blue. It's interesting. I made that blue. Hey, that's quite cool. I'm just like lighter blue. I like that a bit. So actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to select that layer like that, and then I'll jump over onto this one, and with that selected that will allow me to always color within that what's the word, boundary. Okay, so with a big brush selected, and we'll put the opacity down to about 20. Into it. Like so, it's actually going to come off there. I'm not liking doing it with that. It's actually sometimes easier to just freehand it, freeform it, zooming in. Put a bit of shadow in there. A new layer, so I'm going to try to render these. Shadows on the side here. Now they're real, quite sharp shadows, so. Something with the Apple Pencil is if you charge it for like 30 seconds, that's like 15 minutes of use. So if we just pop that in there for a little bit, we should be good. just going to select this again, because that's going to be absolutely hell if I have to re-render something there. Draw this there. Now with a white brush, I'm just going to go over the whole damn thing. And then erase what I want it. Shadows to each, the side of each one. That would be ideal, but not always possible. Look all right. There would be a bit more shadow in here because that would be covered. Thank you. always learn is always go darker than you think you need to with the shadows. I mean, you can very easily take them back with lowering the opacity, so don't be afraid to lay it on. That's looking pretty good. And now let's render the handle. This will be fun. Again, let's select the handle. There we go. Pop some shadows in there. New layer just above. Then we're going to pop some shadows in. Okay. Bigger brush. So I'm at this stage, I'm trying to get the general gist of where I think the shadows would be. So I think they'd be on this side since my light's sort of coming from back and down. So I think there'll be some shadow in there. Some real shadow in there. I just realized I should probably bring a texture in. Maybe a leather texture. So we know how to do leather textures because we've done them. So getting our brush, get black, really, really small. So we're creating a leather texture here, so we're just scribbling over wherever, all over the place. Just scribble. There's no wrong or right way to do this at all. Just try to keep it a nice, good, even, very varied scribble over the whole thing. Now that we've got that, we're going to duplicate. Like so. Then we're going to come into HSL. And then make it white. Done. Now we're going to place the white one behind the black one. And we're going to move it ever so slightly. Just come in nice and close. We're going to move it. It's not very bright, is it? Let's see what I'm doing. It's definitely white, right? connection. It's pretty good, actually. I wonder if it would actually make more sense to get an actual image in for this. Because, I mean, truth be told, I'm not overly impressed with how this is coming out. Gotta keep an eye on time. I mean, it kind of looks like leather, kind of. It also kind of not. Let's find a leather texture. Beige one. Here we go, this is what we're after. Let's try the rest. So this chap. Now that I've got that texture, I'll show you how to bring it in to Sketchbook. So let's get rid of that. Add image moments. Where is it? Of photos. Why is it not here? Hmm. Internet connection. I have an internet connection. Okay. Okay, it should be there now. There it is. Boom. So now we got it. Bring it in. I'm going to make two, so I'll put it there, and I'm going to duplicate this layer, and I'm going to bring this new one down. Yeah, that's good. Could wrap them, I think that would take too much time. So what we're going to do now, I'm not going to do that. I'll delete you. I'm going to rotate you and stretch you. Secure the whole thing. Okay, now we erase what we don't want. Cool. Now I'm going to experiment with putting it under the color, changing our color to overlay or hue. It has no impact whatsoever. Color. There we go. That's what we want. There we go. Beauty. Just seeing a few bits that I could change.
Okay, so I am currently sitting in bed because it is cold here in Wellington. It is now night time. I've done my first day of work. Went really, really well. Thanks for asking. And now let's get back to the sketch. My word, this is dedication. I'm proud of myself. Anywho, I'm gonna get my laptop out for a reference. Okay, where are we at? Alright, we're doing the shadows for the handle. We decided we didn't like that. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna start again. So new layer over the colour. Black. Big brush. I'm just going to erase where I don't think it's going to be. Constantly trying to think where light is coming from to erase where we don't want it. So the light's going to come from above, so it's going to hit that side. Actually selecting that before, but I'm just going to erase it now. I'll select the next one, I think. I think that's what I am learning. Not liking those lines. Just keep going. It's all practice, I guess. And that's the thing, you know. You're going to have good drawings, you're going to have bad drawings. And I feel like this is all part of the process. You're not going to always get better at drawing. It's going to go up, down, 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 slowly working your way up. At the moment, this feels like one of the little down ones. And it is frustrating.
It is sometimes really, really annoying.
You know, that's just any skill, I believe. It takes commitment to get good at it. So that's what we're doing. So what I just decided that I liked how this here, I like how they had that sharp shadow, but I'm going to put another shadow over top of it. Just to blend it in. Always try to focus on the whole, I think it's quite good. You can also see it could be some harsh shadows going in, actually. So whenever you're experimenting, always change another layer. It just saves you so much time. So much time. Believe me. Believe me. They were going to try doing highlights now, shall we? Let's begin with the axe head. So highlight, same thing. Let's see what it looks like. Now, when rendering metal, it's often really sharp angles. So we're going to select it. The axe head again by going down clicking on the paint layer, tap on that, that will allow us to select the paint layer like so, and then we're going to put a paint layer above the shadows on that, which is going to be here. And with that selected, we're going to start liberally applying the white. Now let's do the stem. So I'm trying to create like a sort of bounce light that's going to reflect, because this is a circular core.
Try to get it smooth. This is proving more difficult than I thought.
So let's bring in, some guide. Let's just keep going. I can tell you now, I'm not very happy with this at all. What's happened?
Not happy. Happy. Plug my Apple Pencil in again. Ugh, mate, I am failing hard. Really not happy. Me word. I'm just gonna do the highlights and then we'll call it a night, I think.
it. Alright, I'm just gonna put this together.
I'm just gonna finish this. I'm done. I've had enough of this one.
I really, really have. I'm not entirely sure what went wrong.
That maybe would be good if you guys can point out what you think's wrong with this drawing. That'd be a harsh way for me to learn. Do it.
Okay, let's finish this off. Just gonna make this look a bit more acceptable. Thank you. Groovy. I'm just going to put a circle behind that. I think I'm done. So underneath, guide tool, make it a circle. So there, I think. Actually, I'm going to put a background behind it. Use the blue, make it dark back a little bit. I think massive, passing massive. This is because I've been messy. You can see that little thing. I have to go through and find the things that have come, and I'm going to have to just tidy it up a little bit, which is a bit frustrating, but it has to be done. Tidy back. Thankfully, I think they're all on the slate, which is nice for once. These little details are annoying me now. Let's get it done, Jacob. Just get it done. Add some light to the middle there. And now let's just add a circle. Top of everything. There. It's quite good. Make it a little bit smaller. Just erase a little bit of the circle. Because I always like to do that. I'll just dance to it. See if we can find some sort of elven pattern for the top. Let's try something like that. L. Ugh. My dyslexia is hating me. Elvish. Jewelry. Jewelry? Going somewhere. Let's go pattern. What's simple? It's simple. Jewelry, do they, Jay? Okay, let's try this. Never done this before, so this will be interesting. This will be very interesting. Save image. Cool. Now if we bring this image into everything, perhaps. Maybe it would be kind of good. And we erase what we don't want. Which is like the mass majority of it. Oops. So down, Jacob. Interesting. Ooh, look at that, overlay gets rid of the black. Ah, love it. Hey, hi. What is color? Okay, saturation. Softline does a bad job too, Jay. Yeah? It's pretty cool as well. I think softline is the best. No, what was it? Screen. No, glow. No, softline. No, over there. No, softline. Highlight. What we like. It's quite nice here. Yeah? Okay. kind of adds something to it. And just give it some background color underneath there, because it's no, that's good. Let's leave it like that. You know what? Now that I've put it all together, it doesn't look as bad as I originally thought. It's not bad. It's not as good as I wanted, but it's not bad. I just had a signature and we'll call it a day, I think. Blue beak. Weird. Too light. It's a little flicky. I think this image is distracting, and I'm going to get rid of it. Okay, let's look at what we got. You know what? It's not half bad. Kind of happy. Yeah. I like it.